So this horseshoe magnet is pretty clearly labeled where the poles are, N for north and S for south. If I identify them with an electronic pole identifier, it says N for north pole, S for south pole. Now, with a neodymium magnet, I might also use a marked magnet, like this one, to identify the poles. This one's red on the north pole and black on the south. So if I have a magnet like this and I don't know which pole's which, stick them together. The north pole of the plastic coated magnet will stick to the south pole of this magnet. So I know that's south and that's north. Pretty easy. And you won't hurt another neodymium magnet this way by identifying the poles, because neodymium magnets have a high coercivity. They can't be demagnetized, generally, by another neodymium magnet. With an Alnico magnet like this one, that's not necessarily true. I can identify the poles with a neodymium magnet, and the south pole will tend to stick to the north pole of the horseshoe, and the north pole sticks to the south. If I try and attract the north pole to the north, it repels and flips around. But if I really push and hold on to it, I can force it into position there and actually make it stick. That seems strange. North pole attracting to the north pole. I can do that south too. What's really happening is that some of this magnet material is getting demagnetized. How can I remagnetize this material? Sticking it to some strong magnets. We'll take this horseshoe magnet and magnetize it in the opposite direction and back again, just to show how neodymium magnets can overpower and remagnetize a horseshoe magnet like this Alnico horseshoe magnet. Right now, we see that north is the north pole, S is the south pole, north, south. In fact, it sticks very well. I have here a pair of DAA cylinder magnets. These are neodymium magnets that are 5/8 inch diameter by 5/8 inch tall. A nice strong size. And I'll stick the north pole of the horseshoe to the south pole of S and south to north. And it tracks very well. And we can magnetize an unmagnetized magnet in this way. But what happens if I pull this apart? Spin it around. So I'm putting north to north and south to south. It repels. It doesn't want to go. If I force it, I'm now remagnetizing it in the opposite direction. This happens pretty quickly. North looks like south. South looks like north. Backwards. Fortunately, I can put things right again and put north to south, even though it's repelling a little bit here. Now it's back to normal. North, south.